Now, Google Analytics is a fantastic web analytics tool that can give you answers to several important questions regarding your website, or regarding your traffic, or your online business in general. Who is your target audience and what do they look like? How do they find your website? Which pages generate the most traffic for your site? What is the bounce rate for your website? Now, most business owners and webmasters focus on these metrics and pieces of information, and for good reason. The problem, however, is that they never go beyond these metrics. So while all of these pieces of information are very important to paint the overall picture of your business, they don't necessarily tell you things like how much revenue your website is generating, or if your website is actually helping your business and generating a good ROI. And it's these metrics that are much more important. In other words, beyond the analytics basics, you should be interested in how many leads your website generated for your sales team to follow up on, or how many product demos were requested from your landing pages, how many potential customers subscribed to your weekly newsletter, how many potential leads downloaded that white paper and were entered into your sales funnel. These are much more meaningful metrics if you're trying to improve the profitability of your business. And thankfully, Google Analytics allows you to do all that and more once you set up certain goals for tracking. So let's look at how to set up these goals. As mentioned, Google Analytics can track pretty much everything for you. However, first, you will have to tell Google Analytics what it needs to track. So you define your goals, and then Google Analytics will start tracking the progress of these goals. Now, goals could be anything. For example, white paper downloads, demo requests, multiple page visits, or users spending a certain amount of time on your website. The sky's the limit here, and we won't be able to cover everything in this video. So let's focus on the four different types of goals in Google Analytics and how to set them up. Let's start with where to find goals in Google Analytics. Log into your Google Analytics dashboard and click on the Admin button in the bottom left corner of the screen. And click on Goals. Once you are in this Goals section, click plus Goal to set up a new one. Now, before we jump in on the four types of goals, let me give you some general tips here first. Number one, when you name the goal, be sure to make it descriptive so that you can easily recognize it. The name of this goal is going to pop up pretty much everywhere within Google Analytics, so it should be descriptive and clear for you. You'll be tearing your hair out if you have to constantly go back and check what the goal was all about. Unclear or ambiguous goal names become especially problematic if you set up multiple goals. Tip number two, think ahead before you set up your goals, because Google Analytics permanently applies goals when applying data for your report, and it doesn't allow you to delete them. Yeah, you can deactivate, but not permanently delete. So be sure to think everything through and don't just start brainstorming goals as you go along. Tip number three, selecting the name of the goal obviously isn't the only thing you will have to plan for. Make sure that you fully understand the type of goal you want to track. And with that, drumroll, this brings us to the next and most important section of this video. In Google Analytics, you can set up four different types of goals: URL destination goals, visit duration goals, page or visit goals, and events goals. URL destination goals are one of the most common. These goals keep track of specific URLs within your site, and whenever someone visits the specified URL or URLs, this visit triggers the goal. For example, you have your thank you page URL, and if a visitor lands on this URL, it doesn't matter how, Google Analytics will treat it as if your goal was achieved. The URL destination goals are perfect for thank you pages, for confirmation pages, downloads, sales, and so on. For instance, when someone completes a transaction, he or she is probably redirected to a thank you page. By tracking how many people reached that thank you page, you will be able to track how many people purchased from you. And in that case, of course, you want to make sure that that URL is hidden and not indexed by search engines, so that nobody can directly access it or stumble across it by accident. The only way to land on that webpage should be through the sales funnel after buying the product. That'll lead to 100% accurate tracking. Visit duration goals are used to track how many people stay on your site for a specific amount of time. This type of goal comes in handy when you're trying to increase engagement on your website and increase the amount of time users spend on your site. Now, one important thing to remember here is that you use the visit duration goal type in two ways. Let's suppose that you set 3 minutes as the time you want people to spend on your site. You can identify the number of visitors who stay for more than 3 minutes, but you can also identify the number of visitors who spend less than 3 minutes on your site. Now the trick here is to select a time duration that only some people will spend on your website. In other words, if you select a time that applies to almost every visitor, then the goal will have no real value and you'll find it difficult to use this data as guidance to improve your site. With pages and visits goals, you can also track how many pages people visit before they leave your site. These goals are set up pretty much the same way as visit duration goals. If you want to keep your users engaged and you want them to visit multiple pages on your site, this is the goal you should set. Then you can track for areas for improvement. For instance, maybe you've got a page that inspires 95% of all your users to leave your site. So maybe that disaster of a page is worth looking into. Or maybe you've got a customer support website and you'd like to see where users are on your site when they need to bounce over to your help section. Now the last type of goals is events. These are slightly more tricky and complex than the three goal types I just explained, because first you have to set up these events in your website's code. Setting up these events may require adding JavaScript code to the element you want to track. For example, a button click, playing a video, downloading a file, and so on. Then, whenever a user interacts with that element, for example a download button, it can be tracked with event goals. So once you have that event set up, you can then use it as an event goal in Google Analytics. If you want to learn more about event tracking, be sure to read the Google Analytics Event Tracking Guide. And that's the basic idea behind goals. They play a huge role in Google Analytics, and by setting them up, you can get very specific about tracking aspects of your site that really matter. Feel free to check out our other videos so you can keep fine-tuning and getting the most out of your SEO. And click subscribe to stay updated with new tips and tricks to get you to the top of the search engine results pages.